The topic of our paper is labeled propagation with augmented anchors, where we investigate the principles of unsupervised learning for domain adaptation. As is known to us all, with a large amount of label data, the deep learning has achieved great success in many tasks of computation and natural language processing. However, if we feed the well-trained model with a test image, which follows a shifted distribution from the training data, the model usually makes misclassification. This phenomenon is usually termed the dataset bias. The origin of the bias could be the variance of resolution, the motion blur, and the post-virality, or something else, which are quite common in practice. The direct solution is to collect new annotations for the samples of shifted distributions. However, it is not easy in practice. On one hand, collecting new annotations for every shifted dataset is labor-consuming, since there are a large potential origins for changes, and annotating each sample could be expensive. On the other hand, some annotations are prohibited due to the priority and priority. Thus, how can we learn to generalize to new target tasks? The domain adaptation is proposed for such tasks. As we can see, the easily obtained labeled source data and the target unlabeled data are all adopted as a training data. And we target at transferring the knowledge from the labeled source data to the unlabeled target data. Note that in the traditional domain adaptation, the labeled data and the unlabeled data should share the identical label space. A typical strategy for domain adaptation is the alignment of data distributions across domain. Taking the domain adversarial training as an example, a binary domain classifier is first trained to separate data of the two domains, while a feature extractor is trained to confuse the domain classifier to learn domain invariant features. Once the two domains are well aligned, the task classifier trained with the labeled source data can be safely applied to the unlabeled target data. Although the framework of distribution alignment has been widely adopted in domain adaptation, its weakness has been revealed recently. On one hand, empirically, the objective of domain alignment may hurt the discrimination of unlabeled target data. On the other hand, theoretically, the achievement of domain distribution alignment cannot guarantee the success of domain adaptation. To this end, we propose another perspective for the task of domain adaptation, learning from labeled and unlabeled data. It is based on the observation that the task settings of unsupervised learning and domain adaptation share highly similarity, where the training data includes both labeled and unlabeled data. Given the advantage of unsupervised learning over models trained on labeled data only, it's a direct idea to apply the methods of unsupervised learning to domain adaptation tasks. Thus, a problem arises naturally. Is it okay to apply SSL techniques to the domain adaptation tasks directly? We investigate this problem based on the unsupervised learning algorithm or label propagation. In LP, we first construct a similarity graph with all data, where the nodes are data instances and edges are the similarity between them. To label the unlabeled data, we propagate the labels or labeled data to the nearby points through the graph. Empirically, we found that results of label propagation on the domain adaptation are much lower than that of semi-supervised learning. Go a step further. We analyzed the similarity graphs in the two tasks, and we found that the connections between labeled and unlabeled data of the same category in domain adaptation are much weak. The red points represent the connections between labeled and unlabeled data. The more red points, the stronger connection. To this end, we study how to adapt SSL techniques for the use on domain adaptation. The first solution is that we can apply the semi-supervised learning techniques on the domain invariant feature representations. However, as we discussed before, there are some weaknesses in the domain invariant feature learning. Therefore, we focus on the second one, how to modify the semi-supervised learning techniques for the use of domain adaptation. Before introducing our algorithm, we give the theoretical analysis. The analysis reveals that better results are expected if we enhance the connections between labeled and unlabeled data of the same category. To this end, we propose to enrich the labeled data with labeled virtual instance. We expect the virtual instance satisfy the following two categorization. First, they should follow the distribution of unlabeled data or near the unlabeled data. Second, they should be assigned with suitable labels or high confidence. We instantiate the virtual instance with the estimated category centers or targeted. More detailed clarifications can be found in the paper. We iteratively generate virtual instance with the prediction of label propagation and enrich label data with those virtual instance until converge. The key methods of enriching label data with virtual instance is finished, which is quite simple and clear. How it comes to the analysis and the results? We can intuitively observe that the connections between labeled and unlabeled data are enriched, are enhanced, and the classification results is improved significantly. We also evaluate on the standard benchmark datasets. The Valina semi-supervised learning algorithm label propagation can achieve better results than the seminal domain alignment methods of DAN and DANN. Note that the results of label propagation are based on the feature representation pre-trained on the ImageNet dataset. By enriching the label data with virtual instance, the HLRP improves over the original RP significantly. For example, nearly 9% improvement on the WSDA dataset was observed. Additionally, the HLRP can provide better pseudo labels given a specific feature representation, which can therefore enhance other methods based on pseudo labels or unlabeled data. Here are also some interesting findings. Firstly, such virtual instances do not work in semi-supervised learning, probably since the unlabeled data near the cluster centers are classified quite accurately in semi-supervised learning. Secondly, the performance on the domain adaptation tasks plateau after about 8 iterations. Thirdly, the results of HLRP are quite robust to the noise of pseudo labels. The results of HLRP improve over the set of RP consistently when the noise level is less than 60%. Finally, the algorithm could be fast. In conclusion, although the vanilla semi-supervised learning could be directly considered in the domain adaptation tasks, proper automatic adaptation is expected when applying methods of semi-supervised learning to domain adaptation. We have made our course publicly available. Welcome to my Zoom for details and further discussions.